Hey everyone, it's Jacob here with another daily vlog. And usually at this time, I am in San Francisco at the Mechanics Chess Club playing in my Tuesday night games. But even the chess world is not immune from the coronavirus, and that was canceled, unfortunately for me. But what are you gonna do? Hopefully things get straightened out and I'll be back at the chessboard soon. At least I can play online, right? So I wanted to do a video today because somebody was asking me about something I posted a little while ago, and I talk about these skills and mindsets that future leaders need to have. And one of the mindsets I talked about was the mindset of the chef. And I think the first LinkedIn and newsletter article that I put up was 2-3 weeks ago, and I gave a one paragraph description about each one of those, so I wasn't super detailed because it just would have been a lot. So first of all, if you're not subscribed to the LinkedIn newsletter, I highly encourage you to do that. You can just go on my profile, click on one of the articles, and there's going to be a subscribe button there. So I wanted to just take this time to explain a little bit more about the mindset of the chef and why this is so essential for future leaders. In my book, there are 4 mindsets and 5 skills that I talk about. The mindset of the chef is about balancing 2 ingredients that you as a leader have to balance in your company. Now, chefs always have to balance lots of ingredients, right? Too much of one ingredient, the dish becomes too salty. Too much of another ingredient, the dish becomes too unhealthy. You get where this is going. And there are lots of ingredients that make up a great dish. But as a current and future leader, there are really 2 ingredients that I need you to think about balancing. And that's the humanity aspect of work and the technology aspect of work. And the thing is, you need both of these things. You need the technology aspect for efficiency, for productivity, for decision making, for speed, for innovation, right? You gotta have the technology inside of your organization to be able to deliver, to be able to get data and analytics and insights to create the products and services that you need to create. But at the same time, you also need the human aspect because you need to be able to attract and retain top talent. You need to be able to create and connect that purpose and meaning for your employees and for your customers. And the thing is, if you skew a little bit towards one ingredient instead of the other, things are going to get a little bit off balance. So for example, if you only focus on the human aspect of work, you'll be able to attract and retain the best people. You will be able to focus a lot on purpose and meaning, you know, all that kind of human stuff that we care about. But as an organization, you're not going to be able to be as efficient, as productive, as fast as the market requires, as your competitors are. So you're going to struggle there. On the flip side of that, if you only focus on technology and you have speed and you have the greatest technologies and you can be as efficient as possible, but you can't bring in and attract the best people who are going to help you identify opportunities, who are going to help you mitigate threats or risks that are coming your way, who are going to help create those stories for your customers so that you can build that brand loyalty, you too are going to struggle. So as a leader, the challenge for you is how do you balance those 2 key ingredients of humanity and technology? That is one of the most important mindsets that future leaders are going to need to possess. And the simple way that I like to think about it is use as much technology as you can, use as much technology as you want, but not at the expense of your people. Use technology to help create better experiences for your people. Use technology to remove layers between your employees, between your customers. So use technology, but use it as a way to actually help humans, not as a way to replace them. Think more about augmentation and how you can help them. So couple simple tips that you can start to use. Number one, and this is something I talk about in the book, be a taste tester. So a chef, if you ever see them cooking, they're constantly testing the food, right? They taste it to see what's going on with the dish. And so this is very analogous to what you as a leader need to do. Check in with your teams, check in with your different departments, find out where they're struggling with. Are there opportunities to use technology? Are there opportunities to remove technology because there are inefficiencies from too much tech? So you have to be constantly there, right? Testing, tasting, seeing what's happening. This means that you can't just sit in your corner office. You can't just be in the ivory tower. You got to put the apron on. You got to grab the spoons. You got to grab the cooking gear, and you got to be in the kitchen with the rest of your team. The second aspect of this is paying attention to feedback. Again, using the chef analogy, in any restaurant, the wait staff, the chefs, they always pay attention to which dishes sell the best. Which dishes get sent back where there's still food on the plate versus other dishes where the plate is completely empty. So what are the best sellers? Which ones are not doing that well? You need to pay attention to feedback from your team. Get a sense of what they're telling you. What are your customers telling you? What are employees telling you? You know, you really need to pay attention to where those pain points are, where the opportunities are. And again, you can't do that by standing in the ivory tower. So that's what the mindset of the chef is all about. It's about balancing these two ingredients that you as a current and especially a future leader are going to have to balance. The humanity aspect of work and the technology aspect of work. This is challenging now, but you can imagine what this is going to be like in 10 years. So start thinking about this now and how you're going to balance those two ingredients, because you need to make your organization as human as you can, but you also need to make your organization as productive and efficient as you can. And my best piece of advice is use technology as much as you can, but remove layers between people. Don't add them, and use the technology to create better experiences for your people. So I hope that helps and clarifies a little bit more about the mindset of the chef. If you actually want to get some leadership hacks and techniques from some of the world's top CEOs that I interviewed, go to leadershipreset.com. Again, that is leadershipreset.com, and you'll be able to get access to, I think it's 31 videos now, where I share leadership hacks from some of the world's top CEOs I interviewed for the book, and this is actually stuff you won't find in the book, so it's pretty cool. You'll get them delivered via 3 to 5 minute videos, and I really think it's going to change your leadership game forever. So check it out. Let me know what you think, and hopefully this idea of the mindset of the chef makes sense. If you have any questions, leave a comment. Let me know what you think, or even if you're practicing this inside your company. All right, that's it for me. Probably going to go play a couple games of online chess since I can't go to the Mechanics Chess Club to play over the board. But I hope you're having a wonderful day wherever in the world you are. Talk to you soon.